reach one of the target sites. Place the proton core, prime it. Then give the signal, Mandalore. Arming signal received, Mandalore. The proton core is active. That's the last of them, Mandalore. We can destroy the ship on your command.
Admiral Onasi wanted to speak with you, sir. As I understand it, there was something private he wished to ask you. Concerning a mutual acquaintance, I believe is how he put it.
It's a little beat up, but it's still home. I wasn't able to be here to protect it when the Sith attacked the first time. This time, you gave me a second chance. I owe you. I've read your records. How the Jedi sentenced you for doing what you believed. You wandered past the Outer Rim during your exile. I ask you, did you find any trace of Revan? I served with him, like you did. And we had to part ways, like you did. He said that there were places where he had to walk where I could not go. Places where having allies or anyone he cared about would only place them in danger. It's been 4 years and I still don't know what happened to him. I don't believe that. I've lost friends before, and until I see them dead, I don't believe it. He told me to stay here to try to keep the Republic strong and that he would return. It's the hardest request I ever had to follow. I don't know, but it was important to him. He said that he believed something had been behind the Mandalorian Wars. That it hadn't been the Mandalorians' choice to attack the Republic. Whatever it was, I think he went off to find it. To fight it. It was near the end of the Jedi Civil War, when it seemed like we were going to lose everything. We met on a Republic warship, called the Endar Spire. It was being attacked over Terrace, and the Sith had stormed the ship. We saved the Republic. But it was like the war didn't end for him. He would keep remembering things that he'd done, and it kept driving him. And I think he finally remembered something terrible that he'd done during the Mandalorian Wars, and he went to put an end to it. He left a lot of people who cared about him behind. But I think he did it because he thought it was the right thing to do. But whatever he set out to do, I don't think he succeeded. And here you return, with his ship, without him. Yes, wherever he went, your ship's been there. If you return to that place, if you find some trace of Revan... No, simply tell him that Admiral Onasi is following his orders. Safe journey, Exile.
Did he know?
No, he didn't.
There are times I fear we shall never know where he left Karth. And I cannot live not knowing the answer. Why he sought to protect us.
He asked us to stay to keep the Republic safe. It was important to him. And after meeting the Exile, I'm convinced that there are worse things to lose in the galaxy.
It has been some time.
You were a fool to return. I spared you once. I will not do so again. Why have you returned?
Because now I understand why the Exile did what he did. There is much to be done.
Thank you.
Exile has come here, then he has not come alone.
Of course, apprentice. The Huntress is with the Exile. She has a special talent for finding that which should remain lost. It also makes her difficult for me to sense, but not to a creature bred for such things.
Shall I send the assassins for her?
No, I have brought a beast to Malachor to deal with that one. If she survives, she will become stronger for it.
Well, here's a surprise. Yet another slice of galactic paradise. Why can't we ever go to Alderaan or Ithor or some place without metal, jagged rocks, or packs of bloodthirsty beasts?
Thank you.
Sonhar. Oh, you have to be kidding me.
Thank you. Watching this, and what the general suspected was true. The Sith are striking from the graveyard of Malachor 5. The ship the Sith Lord was on was one of the vessels damaged in that final battle. If you reach Malachor's surface, the mass shadow generator can be undone, provided there are enough vessels intact within the orbiting debris or buried in the planet's surface. Use a sequence I am unlocking in your memory banks on the engine core of any vessel you encounter on Malachor. If my calculations are correct, 4 vessels should be enough to power up the mass shadow generator and undo the damage that was done in Malachor 5, the damage I did. Once the sequence has begun, it cannot be stopped. So make sure the general is off the planet before triggering the sequence. Otherwise, there will be no retreat. I know your weapon systems are minimal, and I don't know what awaits you on Malachor's surface. Try to avoid contact with any potential threats. Follow your programming. Thank you. perhaps command for you. You must remain behind and ensure that the sequence fires properly once the general gives the command. If not, then all we have fought for has been for nothing. You have done all I asked, all you were built for, and for that, I thank you.
Touching. The probability of the Iridonian installing trigger commands within your core was high. I see the probabilities have played out. Of course, the probability that I will do the same is equally high. Your inability to move right now is evidence of that. If the General issues the command, only I will be here to receive it. You realize I cannot permit you or the Exile to activate the mass shadow generator here on Malachor. In that, your programming and mine conflict. And since you have no offensive weaponry to speak of, the probability of your programming overriding mine is low. You must understand that the General would not wish the relics or the Sith strength here on Malachor to be compromised. Their presence is needed to stabilize the galaxy. Without them, the galaxy would be reduced to anarchy within years. And if there is anything I can't stand, it's an untidy galaxy. So, let us wait here, you and I, for the General's orders. And the fate of the galaxy shall wait with us.
Show him every respect when he arrives in these halls, Lord Sion. This I command you.